Well, as you can see, there are a lot of choices in planters and pots, and a lot of different materials that are being used to make these planters and pots. And I wanted to talk a little bit about what your choices are and what features are good to have in a container for using outdoors. And starting with, more than likely, you're going to see a lot of ceramics out there. And ceramics are beautiful, they're expensive, and they're heavy. You always want to make sure that there's a drainage hole at the bottom, because you don't want this thing to turn into a swamp when you're not looking. Next to ceramics is terracotta. Again, it's a fairly heavy thing. It's great for plants that are a little top heavy. It keeps them from falling over. It breathes, so if you have a tendency to be an overwaterer at heart, terracotta is the way to go, because it'll dry out more quickly than other types of containers. But keep in mind, they age with time. They start to fall apart. They also don't like winter freezing, so you'll have to protect them as well during the winter months. I have a tendency to lean toward wood because I like a more natural look in the garden, but wood has its own drawbacks. It rots over time, it discolors, you have to retreat it to make sure it stays looking good. Now, one thing that is a real easy trick for using wood planters is to take old nursery pots, and instead of filling the planter directly with the soil, fill the planter with nursery pots and put the potting soil in the pots and plant those up. When the plants grow out, they'll cover this. You won't even know the pots are there, but it'll make your wooden planters last a lot longer. Plastic or synthetic type planters are all the rage right now. This happens to look like clay, but it's made out of plastic. It's lightweight, it's easy to move around, and it's easy to drill holes in the bottom. Again, drainage, very, very important on any of your planters outdoors, but you can get synthetic plant. This happens to be plastic as well. You want to look at the eventual size of the plants you're planning on planting. If you're planting small plants, then a smaller container is fine because they'll have a smaller root system. But if you're planting larger plants like dahlias and cleome and things that get a good size like fountain grass, choose a planter that will house the eventual size of that plant root system. Now, having talked about the planters, what goes in them is also just as important as choosing a good planter. And MJ is going to be coming around here in just a second to talk to you about potting soil and all the things that are good to put in with your pots in your potting soil.
Well, I have been shopping.
Well, heaven forbid you break a nail. You got some help, huh?
I did. I recruited Jake. You know, he offered to help me.
Thanks, Jake.
You're welcome.
What all did you find here?
Well, you picked out some beautiful pots. And so I decided to make sure that I had stuff to fill your beautiful pots. And one of the first things we have to do is make sure we fill them with the good quality soil. So one of my favorites is going to be the Miracle-Gro potting soil. And what's kind of nice about this one is that it already has some moisture nutrients in it to help it retain more water. Some of my other favorites are going to be like Fertilome potting soil is another great brand. Good soil that's going to help hold a lot of moisture. And that's why you're going for a potting soil and not something like topsoil, because you need it to hold in the moisture.
These are professional mixes. These are what the pros use in the greenhouses.
Right. Well, it doesn't make sense to spend a lot of money on flowers and not put them in a good foundation. You know, part of what people need to remember too is you don't have to fill the entire pot.
Especially on the big pots.
Well, because they become impossible to move or maneuver or anything like that.
Well, you're not going to need all that root room on the really big pots. Say this one, for example. This would be a really good example to start with.
I love your example.
If you're just planting petunias or geraniums in here, they don't need to root all the way to the bottom of this. They can. It wouldn't hurt them. But if you want to save a little potting soil, you can get something like these little deals called upsidaisies. They are designed to fit right down in the pot. It blocks the bottom of the pot, so you only fill it to here. Another thing you can do to save room in your pots is if you've got some old lava rock, you can throw those at the bottom.
Empty water bottles, empty soda cans, styrofoam peanuts.
Even an old nursery pot turned upside down and set in the bottom of the pot. All of those things will help you save some extra room in the pot, and you don't have to use as much potting soil per pot. I always like to put the bigger pots on something that moves. A little dolly that you can move things around makes it much easier to deal with during the season. And also, for some things that sit, that stay put and don't move around, but you want to get them up off the deck or off of your flagstone or cement so it doesn't stain, is you can put these down under plant stand. You can put that underneath. You can break off the extra pieces that would stick out, so it raises your pot just a little bit off the surface.
Gotta understand, here in Colorado, at a higher elevation, that sun really can bake and dry those plants. There's other products that you can purchase to really help with that.
You can add your own soil polymers to help hold the moisture longer. These are called, this one happens to be called Soil Moist. There are others out there. They all do a nice job. Real quick tip on using these, I found out the hard way. Hydrate first. Mix these things with water first. Let them swell up so they look like jello, and that's what they're going to end up looking as, chunks of jello. And then mix it in with your soil. And that will let your plants stay moist at least twice as long. So
right.
That they won't dry out while you're at work. One of the things your plants are going to absolutely require you to do is to feed them, because in those pots, they're going to require you to give them every bit of nutrition they're going to need to grow this summer.
Well, and a lot of people, you think that they think soil feeds plants, but the truth is they need nutrients just like we do, and the only way to give them that is to fertilize them.
Exactly, and there's a lots of different ways to do it. You can use something like this slow-release Osmocote that you just sprinkle on when you're planting, and every time you water, it releases a little bit of fertilizer for, what, 3-4 months?
Well, and the best part about this is for somebody who has a busy life and you want to have successful gardening, it's an easy way to fertilize them and be able to walk away and not have to worry about it. So it's kind of a one-shot deal.
Well, I think that pretty well covers our subject matter in pottery today.
We've talked about pots, but the best part about the pots is now we get to fill them. So coming up next, hot plants in hot pots.
Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Markets. We're working on container gardens today, and I'm using chilies to make some fabulous dishes.